Communication. What are they doing? They are talking. How do they talk with each other? They talk with by phone. Why did they talk? To exchange thoughts of each other. This is called communication. What is communication? Expressing ideas and exchange of thoughts and feelings to others is called communication. We communicate our feelings by using body language like looking, nodding head, waving hand and legs, etc. These are also means of communication like speaking. How do we communicate? We communicate two types. One is verbal communication, the another one is non-verbal communication. Now, what is verbal communication? In verbal communication, people communicate with each other by talking directly or over a phone. What is non-verbal communication? In non-verbal communication, one expresses his or her feelings and gestures, and others understand those feelings and gestures. Dancers, mime artists use different forms of signs language using non-verbal communication. Dancers use mudras to express feelings and emotions. You see here some pictures of feelings. These are called emojis. Nowadays, we use these emojis in social media frequently. Communication can happen in two ways. One is direct communication, the another one is indirect communication. What is direct communication? Talking with friends, teachers, parents is direct communication. People can share their feelings with body parts. You see here, a boy shares his feelings with body expressions. Shaking hands is direct communication. What is indirect communication? We get information when we watch TV or when we watch videos in WhatsApp or YouTube. This is called indirect communication. We use different means of communicate indirectly like postcards, phone call, mail, text messages, etc. Communication from primitive to digital. What are the changes in past to now? Here you see, in ancient days, people communicate with people who are far away by ways of drumming, giving signals through a smoke, sending letters with birds like pigeons. Human runners are with horse riders from one village to another. But nowadays, we communicate with people by using phone and email. Phone used as direct talking and chatting. Through mobile phones, we can communicate immediately. Video and audio conference calls also available in phones. Emails to communicate letters, documents, and videos to others. Now discuss about how the animals and birds communicate each other. Farmers put up scarecrows to keep away birds from picking the grains. Birds assume them to be human beings on guard. this is also a kind of communication for birds. And stretch their necks and head to communicate with each other. Birds and animals express their anger, affection, fear through different ways. They are visual communication, auditory communication, communication through touch, chemical communication. Now, let us learn about one by one. Visual communication. Tortoise and snails retract their head whenever they feel threatened. Threatens means bipedalism. They see any danger, immediately tortoise and snails hidden their head. This is a visual communication. As well as dogs wave their tail when they feel happy or when they saw his master. Next, auditory communication. Auditory means to hear. Elephants trumpet to talk to each herd over long distance. The help of trumpet. In similarly, wolves howl to call other wolves in the pack. Next, communication through touch. Dogs and cats lick their pets and kittens to show affection and clean their bodies and stimulate. This is to direct touch. So, this is communication through touch. Similarly, monkeys and baboons groom each other to show love. The final one is chemical communication. Cats rub against objects to mark their scents. Snakes and dogs use their sense of smell to identify enemies. Using this, our cops use dogs to catch thieves. You see here, a waggy dance is a type of visual communication in bees. The worker bees communicate about food mainly through a dance language. This language called as wagon dance. What we have learned? Communication is the transfer of information from one to another. Communication is of two types. One is direct communication, the another one is indirect communication. We use postcards, cell phones, internet to communicate indirectly. In urban communication, people communicate with each other by talking directly or over a phone. In non-urban communication, one expresses his or her feelings and gestures, and the other understands those feelings and gestures. Animals also communicate with each other by visual, auditory, touch, and chemical means. Use appropriate devices to communicate in different situations. Show love and affection towards the animals.